Now you have, I know you've got cameras in your rig.
Yes.
Do you sell trailers with cameras?
I don't because I don't shop and service.
Okay.
But they do. I mean, it's simple. Pretty much along the back side of your horses is most all trailers is the wiring harness.
Okay.
So you can put fans or you can put cameras or whatever. It's pretty accessible in all trailers.
Okay.
So I don't do it here.
Sure.
But.
They're not a big deal. Mine is completely wireless. Be happy to share the link again. Under $200 on Amazon.
That's
for me.
Perfect.
So I got a wireless one based on a magnet because I use multiple trailers for shipping depending on what we're hauling. And I need to be able to move it. And I mean, I just really
What do you stick it to?
I've got some steel plates and steel places in my trailer, like where my tie rings are and different things. So you have to be crafty if you have an aluminum trailer.
Crafty if you're a horse girl. Let's say.
But for me, I just couldn't go drop, you know, $3,000 or $4,000 in multiple cameras.
No.
So I found one that I could move. It lasts 9 hours on a charge, which typically gets me through a trip.
Yeah.
And it even works at night, so it's great.
Gotcha. That's awesome. Yeah. And then there's a monitor. There's a monitor in the truck to where you can
I just stick
them.
It to the glass, and it plugs in your little, you know, your USB thing or whatever.
That's awesome.
Like I said, I think it was like $179, and I'm on like year three with it.
Nice.
So to me, getting daily use, it's well worth what.
Absolutely. That's awesome.
Yeah.
Absolutely. That's awesome.
Well, and a peace of mind for you and for
a sick horse or a cocking horse.
Sure.
I mean, you don't want to monitor them at all times, but and that's where I've learned how they like to travel backwards. Horses definitely prefer to travel backwards, and I've noticed that on camera when giving them a choice.
That was one of the questions I think that we talked about that you have on the list was whether to tie, not tie.
So we got asked.
Yeah, it's probably
in that big world.
It's personal preference, right? So a woman on one of our groups had said, I'm thinking about tying my horse, pros, cons, anything I should be aware of. Now, several opinions got stated on that, which is what this is, right?
Yeah,
so, yes, always tie them. No, never tie them. They'll get hurt. They'll roll the trailer, whatever. And you actually commented.
I don't think there's a right or wrong answer.
You gave a great comment.
Oh, did I?
You did. I thought you did. Because you don't tie, right? And kind of said the
so, why. Like, slant-wide trailer, I'm going to tie most of the time for the reason that they can't get their head down over the slant and they can't bite the horse next to them.
Yes.
So we had a girl show up at the rodeo 2 weekends ago. She had a brand new expensive horse. For some reason, she put her stallion in the center of her. She didn't tie him. He reached over and ate this new expensive horse's back off. And I mean from the hairline to the tail. This horse has got holes and ditches in him like this. He chewed his back off for a 2-hour trailer run.
Oh.
So. In a slant line, things like that. Now, when you get into over more like, again, that 2-hour trip radius, your horse is going to have a hard time, like, not necessarily breathing, but getting things out. They need to cough. They need to get dust out from your shavings, blah, blah.
Okay.
I will say 100% of the time that I've hauled horses loose in a box stall from $500,000 warm bloods to just backyard horses, they're more comfortable loose, balancing and happy in a box stall where they can move around, eat hay, drink water, ride backwards, put their head up and down. I've even had horses lay down on trips. Foals be able to lay down on trips.
Okay.
So I guess it all depends, but for me, like in a slant load, like I said, I would prefer to tie just to keep them safe.
Yeah, what if you know, I was hauling my horse in my slant load, just him. I left the one thing attached, the divider attached.
You could leave them loose. Yeah, you could use a slant load trailer like that, and I have done that in cases. Yeah.
Interesting.
Yeah.
I love that. Yeah.
I know that they like to ride backwards, and I would prefer them to ride backwards because when you slam on brakes, they're using their butt to hit the front of the trailer wall versus their head.
Yeah.
And all the studies that I've read and I've understood and the videos that I've watched, they just prefer to. It just helps them balance and take the weight of the road and travel better.
Nice.
So, personal preference, right?
Yeah.
I think so.
Yeah.
I mean, I think that kind of falls into however you feel comfortable.
For sure. Yeah, definitely.
But good to know. I like sharing your experience and your
thoughts. Appreciate it. Well, you got a lot of experience, so.
Yeah.
It's good stuff.
It's good stuff. It is.
How hard is it to get finance for a trailer? Is it like buying a car? Is it as annoying as buying a car?
Well, actually, it's harder.
Okay, that's what I would think.
So, very good question, because I deal with it daily.
Sure.
People don't realize, you know, you can go buy a truck, you can get a mortgage.
Yep.
easy.
Sure.
Buy a horse trailer, it's more in depth, I guess, because they don't feel it's something you absolutely have to have.
Yep.
That's also going to be the last thing you're going to, or the first thing you're not going to make a payment on.
Mm-hmm. Yep. Makes sense.
And that's kind of the broad, I guess, definition. But what happens is, and what I see mostly, you got good credit, you know, and when I say good credit, I mean, nowadays good credit's a whole different ballgame. I mean, in the 700s is, mm-hmm. is considered good.
Yes.
What happens is it's dings in your credit. I mean, as far back as you were married before, you charged off a credit card because it was hers or his or whatever, and that was like 10, 15 years ago, it'll come up.
Wow.
It doesn't matter. They okay. will find anything that they see, any inconsistency in. Credit cards are horrible ones. Like, mm-hmm. if they see any late payments on a credit card, medical bills that were disputed, oh, yeah. believe it or not, yes, you had every right to dispute it, whatever, whatever, mm-hmm. it's going to come back and bite you on a horse trailer.
Wow.
Okay. Recreational lending is what I just said. The sure. first part is the whole caveat to why.
Okay.
So, you know, I usually... Actually, every person, I ask a lot of questions because it is a hard hit on your credit. There is no such thing as a soft pull. I don't, if someone comes up with that, I don't think it's true.
No, it's not. I still affect
it. It is, yeah. Right. There is no soft pull. There is no pre-approval with mm-hmm. horse trailer lenders. Now, an outside bank is a different story,
sure.
but as far as the lenders that we use, which are few, there's not a ton of horse trailer lenders, mm-hmm. but you know, those are kind of the basic things. I mean, and I try to like ask customers questions to find out, you know, I'm not trying to purge in your information,
sure.
but I don't want to hit your credit.
She did that for me.
I did. When we were looking for an insurance a couple years ago, she's like, look, let's have this conversation.
Yes.
And we decided at that time to
not do it.
Yeah.
Yeah. At that time, I was like, I'm just going to keep saving cash for what I want.
Yeah.
And it worked out.
It worked out.
Sure. Mm-hmm. Well, not a lot of people know that every time you pull your credit, your score drops.
I know.
So that's, listen up, people.
Well,
every single yes. time, no matter the yeah. why.
Get you a Credit Karma account and keep up with that
there
stuff like I do.
Yeah.
So that's kind of a basic.
Sure.
But then to narrow it down, yes, lending is like RVs. It's 15-year mm-hmm. terms on anything over $25,000.
Okay.
So most of your living quarters, you can get a 15-year term.
Okay.
There are some age limitations mm-hmm. on how old the trailer is,
right.
things like that. You have to kind of work that through. But as far as rates right now, I mean, they're definitely better than they've been,
mm-hmm.
and they're still good right now. But, I mean, I can get as low as 5.5 for up to 15 years. And then there's some lenders out there. There are a couple that individuals can go to directly mm-hmm. online. And that cuts, let's just call it like it is. That's cutting out a middleman.
Sure.
I mean, it's not a... you know, a secret. I mean,
right.
there's obviously stacking in there.
Sure.
But if you go directly to some First Internet Bank, I'm not afraid to tell you the one
sure.
First Internet Bank directly, or I think there's maybe one other one. That's probably the biggest one.
Mm-hmm.
But you can get in the fours with good credit
okay.
right now.
Sure.
So, you know, it's easy to finance a horse trailer if you got all your stuff in check.
Right.
You know, the funniest thing, you know, I talk about is, you know, you come and this is a true story. You know, it's happened multiple times. You come, you want to buy a horse trailer, and you don't pay your mortgage. You know, it's things
you're
like that that are common sense.
Yeah.
And I mean, if you know, that's a major one.
Sure.
They also look, and I find this a lot with young people,
mm-hmm.
and this would be people that don't have established credit.
Yeah.
Maybe they have a great credit score,
mm-hmm.
but they don't have like installment loans.
Right.
They don't have a mortgage or a long showing a car vehicle. I run into that, and I mean,
mm-hmm.
they're just devastated, and
sure.
it's like, let's talk about this. It's not you. It's not your credit. It's
yeah.
the whole recreational aspect.
There's no history there to say, hey, look, I'm
correct.
A good bet.
Correct.
Yeah.
And
right.
I run into that with people, and they get really bent out of shape
sure.
about that and about the dings in their credit that's way far back. I mean,
yeah.
you know, I try to tell people, please, you know, don't take this personal. It is not easy
right.
to finance a horse
sure.
It is not.
Yeah.
Not.
Well, and like you said, get a Credit Karma account. Know what's on there.
Yeah.
There are things that you can do to either A, establish credit
mm-hmm.
or B, improve credit.
Mm-hmm.
Go get a secured Visa for $300 and put your gas on it every month and pay it off every month. That is establishing credit. Look at your Credit Karma account and get rid of stuff that's 10 years old. Get rid of discrepancies in addresses. Get rid of your name not spelled the same way on all three bureaus. That's a whole nother can of conversation, but it took me years to get my credit where it needed to be. And it's hard work. It's not something you just do. I'm going to
dispute right now with one saying that I opened a credit card and charged $44 on it. Okay, this is not my credit card. I don't have it. And I've been in such an argument with them, they put it on my credit recently.
Yeah. Well, and it's more burden to prove it.
And it's $44. Can I pay that? Sure. I mean, ideally, I just called and make a payment,
Why
right?
But I don't
have a credit card matching this account. Yeah. So I'm like, did somebody else open it? Like, what's going on? It's $44.
And there's still a lot of that going on, too, which, you know. So I guess, all in all, yes, it's easy.
Yeah.
Yes, there's great terms out there.
Yes,
it is a hard hit on your credit. No matter, I don't care what dealership you go to.
Sure.
If you give credit, like when you walk into a car dealership, I mean, they're scrambling, give me your credit, give me your credit. It is a hard hit on your credit.
Yeah, right.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
Absolutely. Definitely.